In this video, we'll compare Node.js with Golang by building multiple microservices. For the first test, we'll use Istio service mesh with a new Gateway API, as well as we'll use Gateway API instead of Ingress to expose our services to the internet. You can monitor in real time all your microservices. For example, service A from the Node.js namespace just started to get traffic and getting around 1.5 requests per second. We can see a similar load on the service A from the Golang namespace. I'll explain in detail what the test will look like in a second. You can also monitor the health of your microservices using the Kali dashboard. For example, if something happens with service B, you'll see red lines that represent failed status codes. You can notice that the error rate has increased to 22%. We'll also use Prometheus and Grafana to compare side-by-side those microservices. We'll measure latency from the gateway, as well as CPU and memory for each microservice. You can find the source code in my GitHub repository. In this video, we're not going to go over all of it because it's a lot, but I'll point out some important parts. If you're familiar with Kubernetes, you'll be able to reproduce the setup not just to run the benchmark, but for day-to-day operations. For the first test, we'll deploy service A and service B in Kubernetes. To expose service A, we'll use Gateway API and Istio. When the client sends a GET request to /API/time to the service A, it will redirect that request to service B. Service B will get the current time and send it back to the service A, and service A will send it back to the client. For the second test, when the client sends GET request to /API/images to the service A, it will download the image from S3. For the S3, we'll use Minio, which has S3 compatible API and can be deployed anywhere, including on-premises. In my opinion, it's even better and more efficient from the storage perspective than Hadoop if you want to use it for big data analysis. It simply takes less disk space than Hadoop with the same replication factor. When service A downloads the image, it takes the last modified date of the image and sends a POST request to service B. Then service B saves it into MongoDB object oriented database, which we also deploy in Kubernetes, along with Prometheus, Grafana, and a bunch of other monitoring components. I have a deploy script that you can use to reproduce this setup. I also have a build script that builds the Docker images, but you would need to provide a few environment variables to point it to your ECR repository. Obviously, to make it a fair test, we'll need to make sure that all the pods are deployed on different nodes. For that, you would use pod anti-affinity, but by default, it only evaluates pods in the same namespace. In our case, we have multiple namespaces, which we need to include here. Now, to monitor Istio cards, we wanted to visualize the microservices topology that you saw at the beginning of the video. You would need to add Istio equal to monitor label to each pod and use pod monitor Prometheus custom resource to select and add them to the Prometheus as targets. Kali dashboard works by pulling data from Prometheus. Since we use Gateway API, you also want to make sure that you update hostnames on the HTTP routes that point to the gateway. Finally, for Grafana dashboards to properly work and display CPU and memory usage as a percentage of the limit, you need to include resource block with requests and limits to each pod you want to monitor. To perform the actual test, we'll use K6 monitoring tool built by Grafana team. Here, for example, we define multiple stages with different numbers of virtual users. For instance, in the first stage, for 5 minutes, we'll run 30 users in parallel. Then it will gracefully scale virtual users to 1 and so on. Also, at the end, it returns statistics about the test, such as multiple percentiles. If you want to play locally, you can use Docker Compose to bring up Minio and MongoDB using containers. At this point, we have deployed both service A and service B to Kubernetes. Let's run the first test and use /API/time endpoint. Each test takes 30 minutes to run, but I'll speed up the time. Right away, you can notice that Golang CPU usage is higher than a node in idle state. In my opinion, and based on the Kali dashboard, it's due to maintaining connection to MongoDB, even though we're not using it in this test. However, we do initialize the MongoDB client in Node.js app as well, but it looks like they handle the connection pull differently. After we start a test, you can immediately notice a huge difference in the usage. On the first graph, you can see P99 percentile, which is the time that it takes to complete 95% of all requests. On the second left graph, we have CPU usage for the service A. On the right hand side, memory usage for the same service A. On the bottom, we have similar graphs, CPU and memory usage for the service B. In the first test, we simply return the current time from the service B. You can also notice the spikes. It's due to having multiple stages. The first spike is caused by spinning up 30 virtual clients. Alright, so basically we have two spikes, and roughly in the middle we have a gap with one single user. Now let's run the second test when we download the image and save the last modified date to the MongoDB. It's going to take another 30 minutes to complete. You can also notice a significant difference in the usage. The blue lines represent the Golang services and the green lines are for Node.js. It looks like the latency for the Node.js hit 5 seconds, which could be a timeout from MongoDB or Minio. Finally, in the overall time span between all tests, you can notice that Golang uses fewer system resources and handle load way better than Node.js. The source code for the Golang and Node.js you can also find in my GitHub repository. I'll put the link to the description. If you like this video, you might want to look at another test where I compare Golang versus Rust. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.